My name is Kathy Prevost, and I'm from the Utica area, down in the Mohawk Valley. I lived most of my life here. I still feel like that's home. It's hard. I've lived here for 15 years, but it still seems like home because I go home a lot. I'm from a large family, so I do go home a lot, but it's beautiful here. So that's a big thing for me to stay. Especially if you're going to do artwork, this is definitely the place to be. I don't have any formal art training, but I've been painting for quite a few years. I do sell my artwork. I also have worked as a social worker and in the mental health field for many years, and I like to incorporate my art with sociology, you'd say, you know, with different aspects. I've had to deal a lot with women with various problems and various backgrounds, and I like to look at the sides of women's strength and find their strength, and I like to show that, the different sides of women, because there's so much more than the physical, even though with my artwork I use the physical. I love Van Gogh. I got a hold of Van Gogh when I saw a movie with Kirk Douglas and I was a little girl. Thought that was fabulous. Didn't even know that wasn't Van Gogh himself at that age. But I love Salvador Dali, and I know that's people think that's sick and demented. But, you know, he did have some mental health issues, you know, but I'm happy with that he used painting instead. So I love Maria Callas. I love Rembrandt for his realism, and I don't see why you can't take Rembrandt's ability with his realism in lighting and put that into more modern Van Gogh, you know, Dali type of stuff. You know, when you go to college, they make you take all the gen eds, and I took a course in drawing, which I hate to draw. And one of the things the professor told me, I mean, she shows in New York, her artwork's fabulous, was to don't let anybody change that, because most artists try to not draw what they want on the canvas. Like, I might put a few lines, you know, like where I'm going to put something here or I'm going to put something there for proportion, but I don't ever draw it. And that was her advice, was to don't let anybody teach you to draw on the canvas, and then you'll start drawing it all and need to draw it all. Because you never know how it's going to end up once I start. But I have it in my head, and I just start putting paint on. This is my painting. It's Cleansing from the Ruins. I painted it in 2013. And this is one of my favorites, actually. And this woman represents the United States. And she's naked and exposed and raw. This is after 9/11. This is after our wars. And she's cleansing. And yes, the flag is tattered and torn, and she's, you know, drying herself off with this flag. And this is how the state that I feel we're in, where it's a new beginning. We have these wars that we're trying to get out of. We have been ravaged and dirtied by just all of it that's happened. And she's in the ruins because we still are. We're still having the effects of 9/11, still in the wars. And this is a time of cleansing, of trying to get things back to normal, trying to get ourselves out of these wars and to try to have peace. We, at one time, really thought that we were untouchable, but we're not. You know, and I use a woman because it shows the vulnerability of our country. This is my painting, Little Crow, and this is kind of a tribute to my Native American background. My mother was Native American. Her parents were from the St. Regis Reservation, and I heard lots of stories about, you know, going to the reservation and learning how to make moccasins, and that was her happiest times of her life were on the reservation. She really loved it. My other painting in this style is called Evelyn Bird Talker, and that's actually my mom from pictures of when she was young, but in that era, it was not good to be Native American, so she's more American than Native American, but I put the Indian flair on her to give that back to her because, you know, she had lightened her hair a little bit and she dressed, you know, just white class America. But so I painted her so that to give her her Indian back. you know, because I just thought it was something important to her that she really couldn't share with everybody. I like to do the Native American, and I like the mystical things, you know, the medicine of the Native Americans, and so I kind of did her a little like she's riding on a crow's feather, because a crow is a wonderful symbol, although in, you know, some cultures it's not. It's a very positive thing in Native American. It's like knowledge and education, so the crow is a really great symbol. And I love to do the girls with their dark hair and all their strings of hair, the Native American dark hair. I just love that. This is an abstract. I haven't really named this. I just call it Lady Gaga for fun because it's as wild as Lady Gaga. I love to do my women nude. I don't like clothing to interfere because people always assume things when they see clothing that there's a certain meaning, you know, and maybe they just like that color that day. There's a lot of aspects of women, and I like to portray the differences. And so I don't like any one uniform type of thing with it. I just love the storms and the colors of brightness and just, you know, the different styles of women all in one. And I always have this, I love this, the needle with the thread. And the thread is red because it's actually blood, because women, you know, it's that thread of a woman that's through everything. There's nothing in this world, in society, not in thought, deed, anything, that isn't part of a woman. A woman is the fabric of this world, and I love to portray that, and I love to portray her in so many different things instead of making a woman look a certain way. Or sometimes I do women very demure, but I also know that side of a woman that has a great deal of strength and power, and I like to show that. And I like to show them in bright colors, because they always have, you know, strong women are always in black or red. Well, they're not. They're in yellow and green and purple, and their strength is something totally different than that. It's not that aggressive testosterone strength, but it's just that strength even in the subtleties that women do every day. This is Jail Cat and Lulabelle, and I love characters, and I want to do a whole comic series on them. That this is her cat, Jail Cat, and as like most cats, he gets in a lot of trouble, and she just communicates with him more on a telepathic type of method. She has no arms, but she's not supposed to, because she just deals with this cat mentally, which most cats are mental. So this is one of my favorite paintings. This is my husband's all-time favorite painting. He loves this. I don't know why. This is so not a guy painting, but he loves this. And he just says, this truly represents my personality. This is my painting I did. This is called The Resurrection of Christ with Quantum Physics. This to me was a really fun painting, but it really says a lot. If you know anything about quantum physics, where time and space all lap together, and you know the forces, spiritual and metaphysical, with quantum physics, this is just my crazy interpretation to explain quantum physics without math, since I'm no math scholar.
Have you ever wandered lonely through the woods, and everything that feels just as it should? You're part of a life there, you're part of something good. If you've ever wandered lonely through the woods, if you've ever wandered lonely through the woods, have you ever stared in the